Hello, welcome back to Criminal Procedure. So last video discussion, we have discussed about the jurisdiction in criminal cases. Now let us proceed to the criminal procedure proper, the revised rules of criminal procedure. So first in this rules is Rule 1110 on the prosecution of offenses. Okay, so let's proceed to Section 1. So, institution of criminal action. So, first off, we must, like what I have said in our previous discussions, that we will relate as much as possible the provisions of the revised rules on criminal procedure on the flowchart, on the flowchart of proceeding with criminal cases. So in the institution of criminal actions, we are here in this first step. Okay, so institution of criminal action under Section 1. Okay, criminal actions shall be instituted as follows. Okay, so this is how we institute a criminal action. So first is, for offenses where a preliminary investigation is required pursuant to Section 1 of Rule 112, by filing the complaint with the proper officer for the purpose of conducting the requisite preliminary investigation. Okay, so if kailangan daw ang criminal case before proceeding it to the court, if kailangan daw siya ng preliminary investigation, then i-file siya doon sa office na nagkakandak ng preliminary investigation. And what office is that? It is the office of the prosecutor. Okay? So, i-file mo daw yung complaint with the office of the prosecutor. Okay? For example, sa Tagum City, we have the City Prosecutor's Office or Office of the City Prosecutor in Tagum City. And then, in Davao del Norte, for municipalities, we have the Office of the Provincial Prosecutor located at the Hall of Justice at Capitol, Mangkilam, Tagum City. We also have Office of the City Prosecutor in Panabo City and in the Island Garden City of Samal. Okay, so that if kailangan ng preliminary investigation yung criminal case, then doon siya sa fiscal's office or prosecutor's office i-file. And ano yung mga cases na kailangan ng preliminary investigation under Section 1 of Rule 112? Those are cases where the penalty is imprisonment of more than 4 years and 2 months. So, lagpas, kung lalagpas na ng 4 years and 2 months, and then kailangan na siya ng preliminary investigation. While if hanggang 4 years and 2 months lang siya, okay, from 1 day to 4 years and 2 months lang ang maximum penalty na imposable, then hindi kailangan ng preliminary investigation. And for that case, okay, punta tayo sa B. If hindi kailangan ng preliminary investigation, the criminal action is instituted by filing the complaint or information directly with the municipal trial courts and municipal circuit trial courts or the complaint with the office of the prosecutor. Okay, so kung hindi kailangan ng preliminary investigation, dalawa ang pwede mong puntahan para mag-file ka ng or mag-institute ka ng criminal action. It's either sa Municipal Trial Court, MTC, or the Prosecutor's Office. Okay, pwede din. So, it means nga pwede din na mag-file sa Prosecutor's Office even if the offense does not need a preliminary investigation. Okay? So, kung kailangan ng ganito ang outline. Kung kailangan ng preliminary investigation, i-file mo ang complaint sa prosecutor's office. While kung hindi naman kailangan na preliminary investigation, pwede mo i-file directly sa municipal trial court or sa prosecutor's office. So yan. Okay, so in Manila and other chartered cities, the complaint shall be filed with the office of the prosecutor unless otherwise provided in their charter. So in, kung doon na sa Manila and other chartered cities, meaning ng chartered cities, may sarili silang charter, may law na nag-create sa city, then in that case, sa prosecutor's office talaga i-file ang complaint regardless of whether the imposable penalty for the offense exceeds 4 years and 2 months or not. Okay? Now, the last paragraph of section 1, the offense of the criminal action shall interrupt the running period of prescription of the offense charge unless otherwise provided in special laws. So, we all know already that offenses, okay, like in the offenses under the revised penal code, have a prescriptive period. Okay, so diba? I think you all know, already know this in your criminal law 1 or 2, that a certain offense, an action to prosecute a certain offense must be made within a certain period. And that certain period is the prescriptive period. Na if lalagpas na sa prescriptive period or ma-expire na yung prescriptive period, hindi na pwede or ma-extinguish yung penalty or offense. Okay? So, in this last paragraph of section 1, it says that yung running ng prescriptive period is ma-interrupt siya if ma-institute ang criminal action. Okay, so by filing the complaint or the complaint in the prosecutor's office or the information in the court. Okay, ito, magawa na to siya, itong A at saka B. And then, in that case, pwede na i-file yung, or pwede na na-i-interrupt na yung running of the prescriptive period. Okay? So, however, this has been subjected to several interpretations by our Supreme Court because of this clause here, unless otherwise provided in special laws. Okay, ito kasi na-subject siya into different interpretations because dati ang sabi ng Supreme Court is that in offenses punished by special laws, the period of prescription is suspended only when judicial proceedings are instituted against the offender in accordance with Act Number 3326. Okay? Diba? Kasi itong mga special laws kasi, diba may revised penal code tayo na mga offenses, doon nakalagay yung mga murder, theft, homicide, physical injuries. Sa ano naman, yung wala doon, yung mga special, yung mga other offenses punished under special laws like Comprehensive Dangerous Drugs Act, di ba? Yan, special laws yan. So, yung mga nagpapunish sa mga selling of drugs, using of illegal drugs, doon yan sa special laws. Ang sabi noon ng Supreme Court is that the running of the prescriptive period will only be interrupted upon the institution of judicial proceedings. So, hindi makaka-interrupt yung filing of the complaint at the prosecutor's office. Hindi pa ma-interrupt yung prescriptive period doon. So, meaning if there is already a complaint filed in the prosecutor's office and then the prosecutor will delay the prosecution or the investigation of that case, and the prosecutor delays the filing of the information in court, meaning pwede mag-prescribe yung offense, di ba? Kasi mag-interrupt lang yung running of the prescriptive period upon the filing of the information in court. Okay? So, and also, the Supreme Court has also said that in offenses covered by the revised penal code, the prescriptive period can be interrupted by the filing of the complaint with the prosecutor's office. So, nag-distinguish siya. Okay? So, for offenses under the revised penal code, the filing of the complaint at the prosecutor's office interrupts the running period of the prescriptive period. While for special laws, the running of the prescriptive period is only interrupted upon institution of judicial proceedings, upon, or in other words, upon the filing of the information in court. Okay, nag-distinguish siya. However, may bago na tayong ruling ngayon na na ginawa ng Supreme Court under the Cine versus Sandigan Bayan GR numbers 1698-23-24 in 2013, the Supreme Court has ruled that irrespective of whether the offense charge is punishable by the revised penal code or by a special law, the filing of the complaint and the office of the public prosecutor for purposes of preliminary investigation interrupts the running of the prescriptive period. Okay, so whether it is an offense punishable under the revised penal code or an offense punishable under a special law, then pwede na ma-interrupt ang running of the prescriptive period upon the filing of the complaint at the prosecutor's office. So, yan na ang bago natin na ruling. Okay, so that is for section 1. Let's proceed to section 2. Okay, the complaint or information. So, of course, we have to know ano ba itong dapat natin i-file sa prosecutor's office or sa court? Ano ba itong mga fina-file natin? Para malaman natin or we will know how to, or it's part of knowing how to institute a criminal action. We must know what we are going to file. Okay? The complaint or information shall be in writing in the name of the people of the Philippines and against all persons who appear to be responsible for the offense involved. So parang ganito, people of the Philippines versus Juan de la Cruz. And then if may iba pa, dagdagan na lang to, Pedro Santos, ganyan. Okay, ito ang title daw dapat ng complaint or information. And then, okay, what? Iba ang, kasi iba ang complaint sa information. So, we will define them one by one. Ano tong complaint, at saka ano tong information. Section 3 defines complaint. A complaint is a sworn written statement charging a person with an offense subscribed by the offended party, any peace officer or other public officer charged with the enforcement of the law. Okay, so yung complaint is executed by the offended party or any peace officer, yung mga police natin or NBI, another public officer or other public officer charged with the enforcement of the law violated. So meaning, they are the ones who can file the complaint. So, take note ha, or ang ginamit dito. Okay? So, the complaint, any of these persons may file the complaint. Okay? Kasi may I have a personal experience na kasi yung parties na nagpunta sa akin, hindi talaga sila yung offended party, but they are a relative of the offended party. Next of kin sila ng offended party. However, the offended party does not want to file a complaint, a criminal complaint against the person who committed the crime. So, ang ginawa ko, nag-file, ginawan ko lang ng affidavit yung persons na relative ng offended party para sila ang mag-narrate ng facts. Kung ano ba yung nangyari, may evidence naman, may documents to prove that a crime has been committed and it has been committed by that person. Okay, may evidence, so pwede lang siya inarrate by another person, especially na may personal knowledge din sila sa crime na nangyari. Ginawan ko ng affidavit, and then ang advice ko sa kanila is that pwede na lang yung police PNP yung mag-file ng complaint, kasi allowed, sabi dito sa section 3, pwede sila. Kung hindi mag-file ang offended party, pwede yung peace officer or yung police officer na mag-file ng complaint. Pero ang nangyari kasi, parang hindi kasi alam ng mga siguro ng mga officers doon, hindi nila na-review ang kanilang rules, tinanggihan nila gusto mag-file or gusto i-file yung complaint against the person na nakumit ng crime. Okay? Kasi daw, dapat ang offended party daw mag-file ng complaint. Which is not correct, kasi sabi nga dito sa section 3, it's either the offended party, any peace officer, or other public officer charged with the enforcement of the law. Okay, so anong gagawin nila doon na may crime naman talaga na nangyari? And it is the duty of those persons, lalo-lalo na sa PNP, na dapat imbestigahan yung criminal acts na nangyari, yung crime na nangyari. Okay? So, again, either of these persons or officers can file the complaint. Hindi ibig sabihin na kung hindi mag-file yung offended party, hindi na rin mag-act yung police officer, yung peace officer. Okay, so that is for complaint. Take note ha, it is subscribed by the offended party, peace officer, or public officer charged with the offense of the law violated. And then yung information naman is an accusation in writing charging a person with an offense subscribed by the prosecutor and filed with the court. Okay, so iba siya from the complaint, because yung complaint subscribe yun ng offended party, peace officer, or person charged with the law violated, while ang information is subscribed by the prosecutor and filed with the court. So ito yung sample ng information. Okay, ito yun, yung People of the Philippines versus, dito ilagay yung pangalan ng accused, and then criminal case number, yung docket number, and for what, ano yung ano, na violate na offense, or ano yung crime, and then the body of the information. So the body of information and the signature of the prosecutor. Subscribe kasi siya ng prosecutor. So distinctions between complaint and information. Okay, so ano ba pinagkaiba nila? A complaint is filed by the offended party, any peace officer, prosecutor, or any public officer charged with enforcement of the law. Okay, alam natin yan. On the other hand, an information is prepared and signed by the prosecutor. Okay. And number two, a complaint may be filed in court or in the office of the prosecutor. Okay, di ba? Sa section 1, alam natin yan na pwede sa prosecutor, pwede rin directly sa municipal trial court. But an information is always filed in court. So, hindi fina-file yung information sa prosecutor's office. Kasi, ang information is executed or subscribed by the prosecutor. Hindi niya pwede i-file sa kanyang sarili ang information. Sa court talaga yan i-file. And then, a complaint must be sworn. Okay, so naka-ano yan? Under oath yan, dapat ang complaint. While an information need not be because the prosecutor filing the information is acting under oath. So, hindi na kailangan na under na mag-oath pa yung prosecutor. Okay? Hindi na kailangan yan kasi yung pagpa-file niya ng information sa court is already or in that filing, he is already acting under oath. Alright. That's the distinction between complaint and information. Section 5. Okay. Not really that much about this because but maybe it's good to know sino ba yung mag-prosecute ng criminal action. Okay. Section 5, all criminal actions either commenced by complaint or by information shall be prosecuted under the direction and control of a public prosecutor. Okay, so it's saying na dapat yung public prosecutor talaga ang mag-handle or mag-prosecute ng criminal actions. Okay? That is the general rule. That is the general rule. And in case of heavy work schedule of the public prosecutor or in the event of lack of public prosecutors, the private prosecutor may be authorized in writing by the chief of the prosecution office or the regional state prosecutor to prosecute the case subject to the approval of the court. Once so authorized to prosecute the criminal action, the private prosecutor shall continue to prosecute the case up to the end of the trial, even in the absence of a public prosecutor, unless the authority is revoked or otherwise withdrawn. So the general rule is that it is the public prosecutor who must direct the prosecution of the case. The exceptions are in case of heavy work schedule of the public prosecutor or in the event of public prosecutors. Event of lack of public prosecutors. So, yung siguro busy masyado yung prosecutor, pwede na magpasok yung private prosecutor. Mga dito na papasok yung mga lawyers, mga private practitioners na mga lawyers. So, busy masyado yung prosecutor kasi ang daming cases na hinahandle or kulang yung prosecutor. So in that case, pwede magpasok a private prosecutor. However, there are requirements. There must be an authority by the chief of the prosecution office or the regional state prosecutor. And this, there must be approval of the court. The court must also consent na pwede yung private prosecutor mo mag-prosecute ng case. Then, okay, ito. Still, this is still in section 5, ha? The next paragraph. The crimes of adultery and concubinage shall not be prosecuted except upon a complaint filed by the offended spouse. Okay, the offended party cannot institute a criminal prosecution without including the guilty parties if both alive, nor in any case if the offended party has consented to the offense or pardoned the offenders. So, okay, this is now an exception to the rule here in section 3. Kaya nga sabi ko na if may crime, hindi kailangan na yung offended party talaga ang mag-file ng complaint. Pwede yung police officer. Kaya nagtaka ako dun sa na-experience ko na yung police officer nag-refuse siya na mag-file ng complaint kasi nga hindi daw naman mag-file yung offended party. Bakit siya mag-file? Bakit siya na police officer mag-file eh hindi mag-file ang offended party? Nagtaka talaga ako dun. Kasi pwede naman under section 3. Because that, the general rule is either of these persons ang mag-file. However, there is an exception na hindi pwede na yung police officer ang mag-file. Okay? These are in case of crimes of adultery and concubinage. So kung hindi mag-file yung offended party, hindi talaga pwede mag-file din yung mga police officers or peace officers. Okay? Dapat at the instance talaga ng offended spouse. Pwede, in that case, pwede na mag-refuse yung police officer na, hindi ko to ipa-file, I will refuse to file a complaint against the party committing the adultery or concubinage because it is only the offended spouse who may initiate or institute the criminal action. Okay? And also, another instances is yung seduction, abduction, and acts of lasciviousness. Okay? Ang pwede lang maka-initiate ng complaint is the offended party or her parents, grandparents, or guardian. Okay? And in this case, hindi pwede maka-initiate yung parents, grandparents, or guardian if may capacity naman yung offended party na mag-file. And that offended party chooses not to file. Okay? So dito lang na mga instances, pwede maka-refuse ang mga police officers na mag-file ng complaint. Kasi dapat in the crimes of adultery, concubinage, seduction, abduction, and acts of lasciviousness, ang pwede lang talaga mag-institute ng complaint or mag-file ng complaint is yung offended party. And no one else. Okay, so that is for section 5. Let us proceed to section 6 of rule 110, the sufficiency of complaint or information. So, ito naman, this section enumerates the what should be included in the complaint or information. So in short, it tells us the form of the complaint or information. Okay, isa-isahin natin ha. A complaint or information is sufficient if it states the name of the accused, the designation of the offense given by the statute, the acts or omissions complained of as constituting the offense, the name of the offended party, the approximate date of the commission of the offense, and the place where the offense was committed. When an offense is committed by more than one person, all of them shall be included in the complaint or information. So isa-isahin natin to. Ano ba tong mga ito? Ano ba tong mga name of the accused, designation? So we're glad na yung rules natin nag-specify talaga siya. Ano ba ang ibig sabihin? Ano ba dapat yung pagka-state ng name of the accused? Okay? Nag-provide pa siya ng more specific rules regarding each of this matters that should be contained in the complaint or information. So first is the name of the accused under section 7. The complaint or information must state the name and surname of the accused or any appellation or nickname by which he has been or is known. If his name cannot be ascertained, he must be described under a fictitious name with a statement that his true name is unknown. So, sabi lang dyan is dapat ilagay talaga yung first name at saka surname, and then if kung hindi, kung nickname lang yung alam, okay, hindi natin alam yung first name at saka surname niya, kung nickname lang, pwede yung nickname. Okay? And if hindi talaga natin alam ano yung name niya or nickname niya, then pwede fictitious name. Usually, ang linalagay sa complaint or information is yung accused pinapangalan na John Doe. Okay? John Doe ang linalagay. Okay? So, that's it for the name of the accused. Next is the designation of the offense given by the statute. Okay? The complaint or information shall state the designation of the offense given by the statute, aver the acts or omissions constituting the offense, and specify its qualifying and aggravating circumstances. If there is no designation of the offense, reference shall be made to the section or subsection of the statute punishing it. So, ito yun. Dito yung designation of the offense. For example, ang criminal case is for theft, then ilalagay dito na theft. Okay? Or kung estafa, ilagay dito estafa. Okay? However, in special laws, wala namang designation sa special laws na ano yung crime na minsan sa special laws, hindi dinedesignate kung ano yung crime na na-commit. So, ang sabi dito, if there is no designation of the offense, reference shall be made to the section or subsection of the statute punishing it. So, kagaya nito, walang designation or walang pangalan yung offense. So, pwede na ganito lang gawin. Violation of section 19B1 of RA 8239. Okay? Reference was made to the section or subsection violated. So, that is for the designation of the offense. Next is the acts or omission complained of. Now, that is provided in section 9, the acts or omissions complained of as constituting the offense and the qualifying and aggravating circumstances must be stated in ordinary and concise language and not necessarily in the language used in the statute, but in terms sufficient to enable a person of common understanding to know what offense is being charged, as well as its qualifying and aggravating circumstances, and for the court to pronounce judgment. Okay, so, ano ba, for example, ito is, ito na. Sa information, ito yung mga acts, okay? Ito yung mga acts or omissions, okay, as constituting the offense. And also, if may, kung mag-allege or gusto na may aggravating circumstances, dapat i-allege din siya dito sa body of the complaint or information. Dapat, okay, i-allege siya. Dapat kasama siya sa allegations. Kasi, the importance of this is that the accused must be made known of what offense. Okay, what offense is being charged against him or her para makaprepare siya ng kanyang defense. Okay? So, also, if may again, if may aggravating circumstances, may qualifying circumstances, it must be included in the complaint or information. Because if it is not included in the complaint or information, even if it is proven in the trial, it will not be considered in the decision or judgment. Okay, hindi siya pwede i-consider ng court. Kahit na na-prove talaga na nangyari yung aggravating or qualifying circumstances. That is in the case of Zombilon versus People, a 2009 case. Okay, so I just would like to add pala dito sa designation of the offense, there is a ruling that this designation of the offense is not really that important. Okay, it is not really that important, because what is important is that the body, okay, dito sa acts or omissions complaint, o yung allegations ng complaint or information, ito talaga yung importante na matama. Okay, hindi talaga ito ang this designation is not that important. Okay, because it has been said that this designation is at most a mere conclusion of the prosecutor. Okay, bali opinion lang ng prosecutor na based on the facts narrated here, the crime committed is this. Okay, this designation. So opinion lang siya. Okay, it could be wrong, or it could be correct, but it could also be wrong. Okay, so it does not matter if it would not much matter, okay? Siguro may mag-matter siya konti, but not so much to the point na ma-dismiss yung case, even if mali yung designation ng case. Because, kasi nga, it is at most a mere conclusion of the prosecutor. Opinion niya lang yan. Pwede yang mali, pwede yang tama. What is important is the allegations here contained. Because this is what informs the accused. Ano ba yung charges against sa kanya? Okay? However, in one case, the Supreme Court has said that when the facts appearing in the complaint or information are so stated that they are capable of two or more interpretations, the designation, itong designation of the offense in the caption controls. Okay? So magiging very important talaga or essential yung designation ng offense, okay? If ito namang allegations dito is vague, so pwede siya ma-subject into different interpretations, then what will control is the designation in the offense, of the offense. Okay, so that's it. Next is the name of the offended party. The complaint or information must state the name and surname of the person against whom or against whose party, whose property the offense was committed, or any appellation or nickname by which such person has been or is known. If there is no better way of identifying him, he must be described under a fictitious name. Okay, so dito yan kasagaran, sa body yan nilalagay ang name of the offended party. Next is the approximate date commission of the offense. It is not necessary to state in the complaint or information the precise date the offense was committed, except when it is material, a material ingredient of the offense. The offense may be alleged to have been committed on a date as near as possible to the actual date of its commission. Okay, so pwede na hindi precise talaga yung date. Okay? Hindi fatal sa complaint or information if may inconsistency sa date. However, in one case, in Rocaberte versus People, 193 Scra 192, a variance of several years or statement of the time of the commission of the offense, which is so general as to span a number of years, has been held to be fatally defective. So, wag naman natin ilagay yung date na medyo years na yung period pagitan. Okay? If we cannot be so precise with the date, we must at least not have it in a way na may pagitan na between several years, no? Siguro months. It's acceptable na around in March of 2020, ganun. Committed this crime, yan. Pwede yan, months. Pero kung years na, medyo malabo na yun. Okay? And then, the place where the offense was committed, the complaint or information is sufficient if it can be understood from its allegations that the offense was committed or some of the essential ingredients occurred at some place within the jurisdiction of the court, unless the particular place where it was committed constitutes an essential element of the offense or is necessary for its identification. Okay. So, dapat ilagay yung kung saan na-commit yung crime or kung saan na-commit yung mga essential elements, any of the essential elements of the crime. Because, para malaman natin kung sino ba yung court na may jurisdiction. Or ano ba yung court na may jurisdiction or authority to try and hear the case. So, if hindi natin lagyan, paano natin malalaman kung saan court dapat i-file? Kaya yan ang purpose, bakit dapat may place of commission of the offense. Okay, so that's it for the form or the or those matters which must be included in the complaint or information. Okay, proceed tayo sa section 13, duplicity of the offense. A complaint or information must charge but one offense, except when the law prescribes a single punishment for various offenses. So, as a general rule, dapat isang offense lang ang nakalagay dyan sa complaint or information. Okay. However, there is an exception or there are exceptions when there is a single punishment for various offense. Example is when yung complex crimes. Okay, di ba? May yung mga robbery with homicide, rape with homicide, mga ganon. Compound crimes, special complex crimes. Ito, robbery with homicide, rape with homicide. Single larceny doctrine, series of acts arising out of a single criminal intent. Rebellion based on the absorption doctrine. So, more than one yung offense, pero isa lang ang punishment sa kanila. Okay? amendment or substitution. So this is not much really on hindi to siya masyadong part ng inyong job. However, let's just read it, ha. A complaint or information may be amended in form or in substance without leave of court at any time before the accused enters his plea. After the plea and during the trial, a formal amendment may only be made with leave of court and when it can be done without causing prejudice to the rights of the accused. However, any amendment before plea which downgrades the nature of the offense charged in or excludes any accused from the complaint or information can be made only upon motion by the prosecutor with notice to the offended party and with leave of court. The court shall state its reasons in resolving the motion and copies of its order shall be furnished all parties, especially the offended party. If it appears at any time before judgment that a mistake has been made in charging the proper offense, the court shall dismiss the original complaint or information upon the filing of a new one charging the proper offense in accordance with Section 19, Rule 119, provided the accused shall not be placed in double jeopardy. The court may require the witnesses to give bail for their appearance at the trial. Okay, so proceed tayo sa Section 15, the place where action is to be instituted. So kung saan daw dapat i-institute yung crime, yung criminal case. Subject to existing laws, the criminal action shall be instituted and tried in the court of the municipality or territory where the offense was committed or where any of its essential ingredients occurred. Okay, so if kung sa Tagum na commit yung crime, for example, theft, then sa Tagum na court ang may dapat i-file yung criminal action. Okay, if or pwede rin na kahit sa Tagum lang nangyari ang isa sa mga essential ingredients ng crime, then pwede na sa Tagum na court i-file yung case. Okay? And then, where an offense is committed in a train, aircraft, or other public or private vehicle, when in the course of its trip, the criminal action shall be instituted and tried in the court of any municipality or territory where such train, aircraft, or other vehicle passed during such its trip, including the place of its departure and arrival. So, lahat ng lahat ng places kung saan dumaan yung vehicle. Mapa-train man, aircraft, or public or private vehicle. Okay, kung galing sa Tagum ang bus and then yung crime na commit inside the bus and while on its trip, kung galing sa Tagum and then papunta ng Davao, siyempre mag-pass yun, dadaan yun sa Carmen, Panabo, okay, and then Davao. So pwede na sa mga courts ng Tagum, Carmen, Panabo, and Davao, kahit saan dyan na court. And then C, where an offense is committed on board a vessel in the course of its voyage, the criminal action shall be instituted and tried in the court of the first port of entry or any municipality or territory where the vessel passed during voyage, subject to the generally accepted principles of international law. So, first port of entry or any municipality or territory where the vessel passed during such voyage. And then, crimes committed outside the Philippines but punishable under Article 2 of the Revised Penal Code shall be cognizable by the court where the criminal action is first filed. So, yung mga, di ba, sa Article 2 ng ating Revised Penal Code, yung mga ay mga regarding money, no? Pwede siya kahit saan na court. So kung ano yung court na first na nag-file, kung ano yung court na kung saan nag-file ng criminal action, then that court will have jurisdiction. Okay, that is section 15. So this is, take note of this, ha, this is important in so that the essential element, the element of territorial jurisdiction for jurisdiction of the court will be satisfied. Dapat ito yung sundin natin. Okay, para ma-satisfy natin ang first element na territorial jurisdiction. Okay, section 16, where the civil action for recovery of civil liability is instituted in the criminal action pursuant to rule 111, the offended party may intervene by counsel in the prosecution of the offense. Okay, so kung may civil liability yung criminal action, may nakasabit dyan na civil action for the recovery of civil liability, then in that case pwede daw mag-intervene yung offended party. Kasi, di ba, the criminal action will be under the control of the prosecutor. Okay? At most, the offended party there is or will be a witness to that criminal action. So, yung main player talaga for the prosecution is yung public prosecutor. Okay? Hindi pwede mag-intervene yung offended party. Kasi at most, witness lang siya for the people of the Philippines. Okay, but however, if there is a civil action na nakasabit dyan sa criminal action, then yung offended party by counsel may intervene as to the prosecution of that civil liability. Okay, that is what is meant by section 16. Okay, so that ends our discussion on Rule 110, Prosecution of Offenses. Thank you and see you in our next discussion.